Thank you, Dr. Kedar. On onset, let me thank Dr. Kedar Bhai and HR for giving this platform to share my views regarding the infertility and sexual dysfunction, particularly in the male. I do not require to tell about the definition of infertility to this audience, so I'm just skipping these things. But my concern is why sexual problems are more common in the couple with the fertility problems. Why we have to focus to the gynecologist about the sexual problems? Because infertility treatment often brings stress, psychological demands, and physical intrusive procedure. These can affect a person's sexual self-image, desire, and performance in the bedroom. For many couples, making love is a way of connecting emotional. When their sex lives are associated with failure, frustration, anger, reassessment, they can lose the way of showing their emotion. Many of couples, they always think if they're able to perform in the bed, they'll able to satisfy that partner, they are very happy and their marriage life is also very happy. Once, but when there ever is a problem in sexual problems, it will affect their normal routine life also. I always say if you have the problems in the bedroom, it will affect your life with the husband and wife. It will affect with the in-laws, even affects you with your kids also. But once you solve this all this problem, all the problems are getting over. And because of this, the perform and to have sex to the during the fertility periods, particularly fertile days, there will be tremendous pressures on the male. And because of that, many of time love making become the baby making, play become work. Couples are concerned with the procreative aspect of the intercourse, not the recreational aspect of, about this part, particularly very important aspect of the life. Fertility treatment can make sex less spontaneous and less enjoyable. Always remember, friends, sex is more enjoyable and pleasurable when it will come automatically, when it comes spontaneously. When you plan and do it, it will lose the fun in making in the love. Survey this says there are 70 to 90% couples, male and female both, they have some kind of problems when they attend fertility clinic. Maybe the loss of their sexual desire, sexual aversion and lack of sexual enjoyment. Failure of genital response in male particularly is the erectile dysfunction, orgasm dysfunction like premature ejaculations. Whereas in the female, there is a loss of vaginismus might be the primary or secondary and dyspareunia. Many of times when couples come with the fertility problems, they have the problem of non-consummated marriage. And vaginismus is one of the main cause in the female factors. Where the vaginal muscles are got in the spasm, and they are not able to, she's not able, allowing her husband to penetrate, and they are not able to consummate the marriage. And when there is a fertility problems, many of times gynecologists had advice to keep the relations during the particular days, fertile days. And when there is a particular fertile days are advice, many of time what will happen, husband have the performance pressure, performance anxiety, and because of this anxiety, many of time he do not get proper erection, or he may lose his erection prior to penetration. So what will happen, this couple, what they will plan, they will avoid foreplay. Once they will avoid the foreplay, there will be lack of lubrications, and whenever they try to penetrate, it will be dyspareunia. In the male, there will be stress of infertility, anger, panic, despair and grief. Distress of investing, particularly about semen analysis. Whenever the gynecologist or fertility specialist asks them to go and give the semen samples, there will be many couples, they say it's very difficult. They do not able to produce the semen, or they do not able to give the they do not get proper erection in the laboratory. Why? Because many of time there will be see, cement room is are not good enough. Atmosphere is not good. Many of times, that's the table or the books they give, erotic books they give to stimulate, to arouse the male. That books are not proper or books are so dirty and rooms are so dirty. So men do not get proper environment and mood, and because of that he may not able to produce this he may not get proper erection, and he may not able to produce the give the sample of semen, and because of, once or twice they will fail, they have the distress or they have the so much anxiety about giving these things. And many of time patients do not have proper sexual education, that also lead to the these problems in male. Whenever the patients, male patients come for fertility, there are so many things, factors are there for the fertility problem, like defective spermatogenesis, obstructive efferent ducts, error in the seminal fluid. And as sexologist, my focus will be the failure to deposit sperms high in the vagina. So what are the reasons why they are not able to deposit sperm in the high in the vagina? There are two factors. One is erectile dysfunction, and second is ejaculatory defect, like premature ejaculation, retrograde ejaculation, or absence of ejaculation. Let's go about the erectile dysfunction first. Erectile dysfunction is the inability to achieve or maintain an erection of adequate quality for penetration. There are so many anxiety about, when you they do not get proper erections. There are so many anxiety. You have to make them calm about that things. You have to make them understand that the like of what other organs we have, like nose, eyes, ears, this is like other body part only. Penis is like other only body part. What will happen when you have the fever? You'll go to your family physician. Family physician diagnose whether this fever is because of malaria, because of dengue, or viral fever. Now, once he will diagnose, according to that, he will give. What will happen once they will give medicines? You will be all right within a week. Same thing happened when you have the erectile dysfunction. You will go to the sexologist or any other doctors who are treating the sexual medicine, and they will diagnose why you are having the erectile dysfunction. Once they will able to diagnose whether it's a vascular origin or it's neurological or is a psychological erectile dysfunction, now according to that they will give the medicines and you will be all right. That is, you are not only person who are facing this problem, so you have to actually answer. Sure, they will be a little bit anxiety will be over, and they will be more comfortable to discuss, and they are ready to take the treatments. Erectile dysfunction and premature ejaculation. Erectile dysfunction and premature ejaculation can be the cause of the fertility, or the erectile dysfunction and premature ejaculation can be either cause of the fertility problems or consequences of the infertility. And infertility may increase or already presents erectile dysfunction or premature ejaculations. There are 5% of cases when patients attend the fertility clinics, they will suffer from the erectile dysfunction. But there are 35% of male who have the infertility problems, they also have the premature ejaculation problem. Why this number is so high? Because many of time they go to the fertility clinics, they are advised to keep the relations only during the fertile days, and remaining days they have to abstain from the sexual relations. And because of this, many of time what will happen, there'll be if they have a little bit even premature ejaculation, it will be aggravated, and they will many of time they will not able to consummate, or they will prior to penetration they ejaculate, or if they even ejaculate, they within one or two strokes they will ejaculate. So this is a problem when they attend the fertility things. Second thing, now come to the erectile dysfunction, main thing. We always think one naughty thoughts can make you hard. Friends, is not true. If I want to lift my this finger, I need everything intact. I need intact bone, I need intact nerve supply, I need intact vascular supply, I need intact muscles also. And we think just simple naughty thoughts can give you heart. No, friends, it's not true. You need intact vascular supply. You need intact nerve supply. You need intact endocrine system. You need intact smooth muscle. And above all, believe me, friends, if everything is normal, but there is no right mood or environment is not good, you may not get proper erection. If there is any diversion or any variation in any of these things, can lead to the erectile dysfunctions. But what happened? When they go to the different doctors or healthcare professionals for their fertility treatment, they go months and months for investigations or expensive treatments. But basic thing, what will happen? They miss the taking a detailed sexual history. If you miss this sexual history, you put your patients in heavy investigations. They are putting time, wasting their time in investigations and treatment. So I'll give you one simple example. This is a real thing happened. The UN General Secretary once asked, "Can someone please tell me the solution of food crisis in the rest of the world?" And you won't believe what amazing reply they get it. Countries representative, African people said, "What is food?" European says, "What is a shortage?" American people says, "What is the rest of the world?" And Arabian says, And I added one thing over here. The word I had added myself in these questions was the please. And when I added this please and when asked the Indian delegate, they says, "What do you mean by the please?" What I mean to say, the clinical presentation of sexual problem is often influenced and shaped by the cultures it belongs to. In short, it's a culture bound. When we go, when we take the history from the Western culture or Western literature, we try to follow that things. Many times we miss the diagnosis and we are not able to clinch the things. So we need to take a proper sexual history from the Indian aspect. Many of time, what will happen? Gynecologists they say when they treat the infertility things and the person say, "I am not having proper erection," or "We are not able to keep the relations," or "We have some sexual problems." They say, "This is not my cup of tea," or they are not looking hard enough, or they avoid to discuss about this point. If you do that things, you are not doing justice to your patients, because 21% of male have some problems when they attend the infertility clinics. There are 21% people have some sexual problems. This is a big number. So friends, you need to take proper detailed history, and there are two certain questions, particularly these two questions, you need to ask direct questions. Are you sexually active? Many of time, what will happen? Once they get married, they are not able to consummate their marriage for 1 or 2 months or even longer durations. They will stop doing any sexual activity. Once they saw, but after 1 or 2 years, when their family members force them to send to the gynecologist or fertility clinics, if you do not ask these things, are you sexually active? So you are putting the patient unnecessary investigations and the treatment part. So you should ask directly, are you sexually active? You should not assume that all the married couples are sexually active. And second thing, do you have any sexual difficulties? There are so many things out there. They are not able to penetrate. They have the premature ejaculations. They have the vaginismus. There are many of things are there. So you need to ask about these two questions. Direct questions need to ask couple when they attend the fertility clinic. You need to ask certain general questions. Do you and your husband have the similar level of sexual interest? Do you have any difficulty becoming sexually aroused? Is there your sexual intercourse or sexual relations are painful? And do you use any lubricant? believe me, friends, as a sexologist, I'll put these things, lubricant, as a main culprit for the fertility clinic, fertility problem. Many of time, what will happen in this beginning of the marriage, they use the lubrications to ease their penetrative sexual activity. And these habits, they continue even after 1 or 2 years also. And because of this lubricant, it will hamper the motility, and this motility hamper can lead to the fertility problem issues. So you need to ask about their lubrication history also. Once history is over, one has to do the physical examination in male. Phimosis and paraphimosis must be ruled out, because many of them, because of this phimosis or paraphimosis, there will be pain during the intercourse, and because of this pain, they will subside, that they will lose their erection and they are not able to penetrate. Local injury should be ruled out. Peyronie's disease also should be ruled out, because in the Peyronie's disease, there will be a band of the penis. Usually it happened after the age of 35 years, but nowadays people are giving more priority in the career, so they get married late, and because of this thing, we should rule out the Peyronie's disease, and bulking the penis is also rule out, because many of them aggressively keeping the relations can cause the injuries to the penis, and fracture of penis is one of the cause for not able to penetrate during the sexual relations. So you should allow bulking of the penis in the physical examination. One must also look for the any abnormality in the testes, because undescended testes can lead to the azoospermia, or even size of the testes also we have to rule out things, any abnormality. One has to rule out, look for the infection or inflammation in the penis, particularly in diabetic patients. There are the infections or inflammation in the penis. You should look up the pulses also in the female. Pervaginal examination has to be done. Vaginismus has to be ruled out, because 35% of non-consummated marriage are due to the female factor, and female factor, vaginismus is one of the culprit, main culprit for the marriage, where there will be a spasm of the vaginal muscles. And hymen and sphagnum, one has to do rule out. I'll give you one very interesting case. This is the just last week, this case was there of non-conjugated marriage, married for last 3 years, but not able to consummate marriage, as husband was not able to penetrate. This case was referred by the senior urologist of Ahmedabad. When we do the examination, we are able to diagnose the septate hymen causing the obstruction. It is important to note that most often the patient with microperforated or septate hymen will present when she has difficulty placing tampons, has retained the tampon, or unable to have penetrative vaginal activity. Friends, believe me, these patients were married for the 3 years and they were not able to consummate it. They have consulted many people, but people take it granted that everything will be normal, and they have not done the female vaginal examination. Small incision had saved their marriage. Marriage was on the verge of divorce. I always say, don't make big issue over the small issue. Always look for the hymen. After examination, you require certain investigation, complete blood count to rule out any anemia, because anemia can lead to the weakness and tiredness, and because of this tiredness, there will be a lack of desire in the sexual activity. One has to rule out the blood sugar, serum testosterone, serum prolactin. Serum prolactin should be always taken as a pool sample at an interval of 20 minutes. One has to collect blood 3 times, because this is a pulsatile hormone. So if you do not take a pool sample, you might get a false result. Lipid profile should be get, liver function test, because we all know these testes are testosterone are manufactured by the testes, but get metabolized in the liver. So is there any pathology in the liver can lead to the production is also normal, but then metabolism, if any pathology in liver, it will not have the proper metabolism, and because of that, it will not act on the target organ, and thyroid function test should be ruled out. Certain advanced investigations also has to do, rule out sexual dysfunction in the male, color Doppler for erectile dysfunction to find out whether is what is the origin of the erectile dysfunction, whether is a venous leakage or arterial problems. Vasoactive injections of papaverine or Bimix can be given. Advanced test is RIGI scan plus evaluation, we have to do it. For RIGI scan evaluation, patient has to admit two nights in the hospital. Around 8 o'clock, we admit the patients. Next day morning, 7 o'clock, he will be discharged. These machines, what we do, when person's male goes in the REM sleep, we'll start measuring the erection. What is the percentage for erections on the male gets in the tip of the penis? What is the percentage he gets in the base? What is the tumescence? Size of the tumescence? What are the, if he's not getting proper erection or blood supply, why he's not getting? That also it will get measured. Like our ECG, it will measure penile graph. When this is very sophisticated investigation, even in the law of court, it will be approved when the divorce case are there. Husband say, I'm potent, wife is important. What is going on in the four wall of the bedroom? No one knows who is right and who is wrong. How to prove? That time this RIGI scan plus evaluation will be very helpful. Even the rape case, when the someone says I'm important, I do not get proper erection, how can I rape the person? So that time this RIGI scan plus evaluation will be helpful. Even during this Asaram case, Gujarat government asked me to get this RIGI scan of Asaram Bapu, but law says if a culprit says I do not want to give any evidence for me against me, then they can refuse for this investigation, and Asaram has refused for this RIGI scan evaluation. Other investigations are not that routinely we are doing, but they are also sometimes they are very useful. Now come to the when you everything is done, your diagnosis is done, investigations are done, histories are taken. Now the you have to treat the patients. So what are the line of treatment? First is the alteration of modification of risk factor. Like if person is more, having vices like smoking, alcohol, or chewing tobacco, you should ask them to stop this all these things. Because see there, I'll tell you there are four S, big four S, which can lead to the erectile dysfunction. What are these big four S? First S is smoking, any form of tobacco, whether it is a smoking, whether it is chewing tobacco, or whether it is a gutka, can lead to the erectile dysfunction. Second is a scotch, whether it is a 5 rupees alcohol or 5,000 rupees alcohol, whether it is a rum, beer, whiskey, any kind of alcohol can lead to the endothelial dysfunction, and endothelial dysfunction can lead to the erectile dysfunction. Third is S is stress, and fourth is sugar. So you need to ask your patients to, when they have the erectile dysfunction, to alter the or modify their lifestyle. They need to do walking, they need to do exercise and all these things. Second part is very important is sexual counseling and education. You have to counsel. We always think this is a era of internet and everyone knows about all this, about the sexual function, how to perform and what to do and all these things. But believe me, friends, many of time even educated people from influence class of the society, they do not have the basic knowledge of the sexual performance. So you may have to educate about this thing. Once everything is done, you have diagnosed that thing, then you can offer according to the things. If hormone deficiency is there, you can give the testosterone. Testosterone gels are available, testosterone tablets are available, even injectable testosterones are available, and even nowadays in India, testosterone patches are available. So according to that, if any hormonal imbalance is there, you can give that things, or PDE5 inhibitor like sildenafil, tadalafil are very useful in erectile dysfunction. Local therapy, when you diagnose the person having the psychological erectile dysfunctions, you can give the touch therapy. With this touch therapy, there will be less, you will be treating the anxiety. And with this, when you are treating the anxiety and psychological erectile dysfunction, you will able to cure that things without any medication. When oral medications are not working, when injectables are not working, when local therapies are not working, rarely we use the surgical therapies. That's an implant we are doing. So before ending my talk, let's this is a conclusion of my these things. Every gynecologist should be aware the relations between the infertility and sexual problem. Sexual problems are common in infertile couples. Taking sexual history before, during and after treatment of infertility treatment is very, very essential things. Erectile dysfunction causes infertility can be successfully treated, which can save the time, efforts and money of investigation and treatment of infertility. Educating of couple on the impact of treatment on their sexual infunctions and asking them to help if any problems are arise. These are the some strategy I have planned when couples attend fertility clinic and they have the sexual problems. You need to tell them, focus on your relations as a couple. You are not individual. You need to treat as a couple. Talk about the sexual problems. Talk with each other. What you like, what you do not like. You need to talk with your partner. Face the sexual challenge as a partner. You cannot clap with a single hand. Same way when you come to the for sexual problems, if partner is there, he comes with along with you, treatment will be very easy and speedily we can get the results. Do it anyway. Sex intimacy. Many of time what will happen, in beginning once they fail, they do not try to keep the relations. They do not even attempt to keep the relations. And after 2 or 3 years of marriage, they are not able to, she is not able to get pregnant. The family places they send to the gynecologist and then they will go to the gynecologist. They are able to know these couples are not keeping a relation at all. So always I encourage your patients to keep the relations. What will happen? You will get failed. But if you do not keep relations, you will be 100% failed. If you keep the relations, there are chances you will be able to success. So you need to keep relations. Avoid ritualized mechanic and procreative approach to the sex. Make time for love making, not baby making. Plan sexual activity because you need to foreplay should be enjoyable and it should be interesting. It should be not monotonous. If you are married since last 6 months, you are doing the keeping the sexual relation with the same partner, same places, same bedrooms, in same position. There will be monotonous. I do not say you need to change the partner, but at least you can change the different positions. You can change the atmosphere. You can change the places. If you do that things, there will be more interest for your sexual pleasure. Devote time to activity and interest that you enjoy together. I always say people who walk together, have coffee together, who laugh together, have great sexual life together also. Know that your fertility does not define you. Know that sexual challenge during these times are normal. You are not alone who are facing this problem. There are 30% of couple. They are not able to consummate their marriage for first 1 year. So you should encourage the couples to keep the relations and tell them you seek the help and you know you are not alone. Friends, believe me. If you treat the disease, you win or you may lose. But you treat the persons, I guarantee you will win, no matter what the outcome. Thank you. Thank you very much.